we now have a very serious problem that has infiltrated, as we know, on late night television. And where has that been infiltrated any worse than Saturday Night
Live? I mean, really, all these guys are just such like little corporate whores. They're just little corporate whores.
It's not even funny anymore.
No, well, it's look, they so haven't been bad. Funny it's in so a long time.
And there's only been a handful of runs where it was actually really good.
But here's today, the thing.
It's terrible.
He is, so our bootlicker of the week is none other than Lorne Michaels. But what's so like ridiculous about him is that he does it contrary to the wishes of his people on his staff and his writers and his actors and his comedians. And, you know, they don't want this. So anyway, he is having none other than one of our members from the Oligarch Chronicles, Elon Musk, will be hosting Saturday Night Live. Now, personally, I don't watch Saturday Night Live. I don't really care.
Neither do I.
I couldn't care less. But I think that that's really frustrating for people that work there. They were also like this when he wanted Trump to come on. They hated having Trump there. They didn't want to work with him. And apparently everything fell really flat because they were just not wanting to work with him. So who knows what's going to happen with Elon Musk. But I would like to point out the double lick.
Yes.
When you got to taste both boots.
Well,
I love the double lick.
You know, who knows what type of a contribution, you know, Elon has made to Comcast or who knows what. I mean, again, I don't want to assume anything, but what I can say, and I think most would agree, is Lorne Michaels has been the executive producer for, you know, the showrunner for Saturday Night Live since it began.
He's basically the Nancy Pelosi of late night television.
He's been there for 46 freaking years.
Yeah.
You believe that?
Yes, I do, because I actually was a little kid when he was there. Oh, yeah, I do know that.
And there was a time where he knew what he was doing.
Well, and this is the thing about a lot of people, that they get very stuck and very comfortable and very complacent, and they get very entitled. And I think it's the same in multiple industries. Like I said, this is no different than what we have sitting in Congress. And is that any different than Chuck Schumer?
Well, Chuck Schumer, you know,
just sitting there forever.
Yeah, this and you know, it to me, it really speaks to a really big problem where no one wants to voluntarily give up their power. Mm. Nobody. It gets to a point where it's like Lorne knows that he really shouldn't be doing what he's doing. The show hasn't evolved. It's totally flat. It has been for many, many years. I don't know who the hell watches Saturday Night Live.
And it's sad because there are actually some decent people on there.
Sure. There are some. Listen, you know, to me, I look, you could say all you want about, you know, the people that have been on the show for a while. Some of them are talented. I'm not going to say that is not. Look,
like I like Kate McKinnon.
Kate McKinnon,
I think she's great.
Is absolutely a super talent.
Yeah.
You don't have to like her political leanings.
No, that's irrelevant.
The truth is she's done some amazing skits and she's very funny. She is. But other than her, there really isn't a lot to, you know, write home about.
No, it hasn't been funny in a long
time. There's been what I would call three heydays of the show. There was the original cast and a couple of other add-ons along the way, but essentially the ones that started
Eddie Murphy.
Yes, but that wasn't a great run of the show. Eddie Murphy was on at a very interesting time when the show wasn't that good. The point is, they had a great run in the mid-70s with the likes of Bill Murray, Gilda Radner, Dan Aykroyd, Chevy
Chase, the original
Chase,
not
Jane
ready
Curtin,
for primetime players,
John Belushi. Then it was very, look, they went through many lean years until the late 80s where they got Phil Hartman, they got Dana Carvey, they got Kevin Nealon, where they, you know, you had Chris Farley, who eventually came on. Jan Hooks was really good. They had a really good cast.
And then
you had the late 90s, early 2000s, which of course was Will Ferrell. You had, you know, look, Jimmy Fallon.
Right, you're
had
going
his
through
moments.
The entire history of the script. The
but
point,
my
is,
point is that they've had a few runs where they were really good. But as a body of what the show has been over time, it's not that good.
No, it really isn't.
And now it is really coming to a head where Elon Musk, yes, Mr. Super Billionaire, I'm saving the planet with my electric car.
This is what they're
Elon
speaking
Musk.
Truth to power. This is a show that's supposed to be speaking truth to power. This is a show that's supposed to be that.
And let me say this for people in the audience who think that we don't care about what Elon Musk initially is fighting for the most part. What he's fighting for is actually good, but you can fight for good things and still be a complete freaking tyrant. That is entirely possible
now,
as well.
We can address.
Thanks for watching. If you want to support our mission to transform politics into service, please like this video, subscribe, follow us on social media, and consider joining our Patreon, where you'll get early access to our interviews as well as other exclusive content. Links are in the description. Peace out.